I welcome all everyone for the first day of investment, basics of investments. And investment is knowledge pays the best interest. When it comes to investing, nothing will pay off more than educating yourself. Do the necessary research and analysis before making any investment decisions. So, Money Barters established in 2021. We are at Money Barters offering comprehensively competitive client customer services and academic-oriented professional financial consultancy in the arena of funds allocation, portfolio management, asset management, capital structuring, taxation and business regulatory framework. The services we provide are online payment and electronic transaction assistance, bank account opening and banking assistance, loaning documentation and credit rating assistance, financial and tax training and education, financial research with market analysis, financial consultancy with tax management, insurance assistance, TDS solutions. Thank you. I welcome all honorable authorities. So before starting the meeting with positive vibes, if you have any questions during the presentation, please type them in the chat box, and we'll also have time for the questions at the end. Once again, warm greetings on behalf of Career Dreams Education and Money Barters to all the participants. Today's presentation is taken by Deeksha Ma. So I'll hand over my mic to Deeksha Ma.
Thank you, Aishwarya Ma. So starting with the presentation, just give me a second. Okay, so basically we are going to start on today we are going to start with the workshop on investment. So first, before starting, I want to tell you a story. एक आदमी था जो बचपन में बचपन में काफी गरीब था, बट एंड उसके पास नौकरी वोकरी कोई थी नहीं. कुछ फाइनेंशियल प्रॉब्लम्स की वजह से वो घर छोड़ के चला गया, घर छोड़ के वो दूसरे सिटी में गया, बड़ी सिटी में गया नौकरी करने के लिए. उसके जेब में सिर्फ 500 रुपए थे एंड वो बड़ी सिटी में गया जॉब करने के लिए. जॉब करते करते उसने वो पैसों से ऑब्वियसली कुछ टाइम के लिए सर्वाइवल उसका हुआ, एंड आफ्टर दैट यूं ही चलता रहा. देन उसने जॉब किया. जॉब में उसको काफ़ी सारी चीज़ों का एक्सपीरियंस आया, काफ़ी सारी चीज़ें एज इन बुक कीपिंग, अकाउंटिंग एंड ऐसी काफ़ी सारी चीज़ें थी जिससे कि उसने काम करना चालू किया. एंड उससे आगे बढ़ते बढ़ते उसने किसी आदमी के साथ में पार्टनरशिप किया बिजनेस में. कुछ टाइम के बाद में उसने बिजनेस स्किल्स तो सीख लिए, लेकिन उस आदमी के साथ में उसका पार्टनरशिप नहीं जमा. उसने फिर पार्टनरशिप तोड़ दिया एंड आगे जाकर उसने अपनी खुद की कंपनी खोली. ऐसे बिजनेस करते करते एंड काफ़ी सारा स्टॉक्स के बारे में, बिजनेस के बारे में, अलग अलग चीज़ों के बारे में इंफॉर्मेशन कलेक्ट करता रहा. एंड ऐसे इंफॉर्मेशन कलेक्ट करते करते उसने इन्वेस्ट करना शुरू किया. एंड इन्वेस्ट करते करते जब वो आदमी जब वो अपने मरने की स्टेज पे आया, तब उसके पास आप सोच सकते हो कितने रुपए थे. उस आदमी के पास 75,000 करोड़ रुपीस थे जब वो मर रहा था. क्या आप सब में से कोई बता सकता है कि ये आदमी कौन था? एनी वन ऑफ यू? हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस मैम, आई
कैन. यस मैम, आई ऑडिबल.
कैन एनीवन टेल मी?
अप्पा
मैम, आई थिंक मोस्ट ऑफ देम फ्रॉम आंध्रा, वी कैन कन्वे देम इन इंग्लिश.
ओके ओके ओके, सो देयर लाइक शुड आई रिपीट द स्टोरी?
मैम आई थिंक सो. नो मैम, बट फ्रॉम नाउ ऑनवर्ड्स यू कैन जस्ट गो विद इंग्लिश.
या ऑल राइट. So,
otherwise you all can, if there is any issue.
Okay. Sorry, ma'am. Sorry for the interruption. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, I think if there is any issues they are not understanding, they can at least write in the chat box, whatever their queries are. Okay, so participants,
yes, ma'am, sure,
are free to use the chat box. Okay.
Okay. So let me tell you that man was Dhirubhai Ambani. Jise ki hum, like we all know that he is one of the most richest man in India. Like he was the most richest man in India. Now, talking about investment, can anyone please tell me who is the most famous investor? Anyone?
Rakesh Chintawala.
Okay.
Warren Buffett.
Warren Buffett.
Okay, great answers. Yeah, Rakesh Jhunjhunwala is even I follow his news like every day. Like he's the someone like who influences the stock prices. So he is someone like Warren Buffett of India. So Warren Buffett ka ek famous quote hai, if you don't find a way to make money while you sleep, you will work until you die. These are the lines by Warren Buffett. अगर आप जब सो रहे हो उस वक्त भी अगर आप पैसे जनरेट करना नहीं सीखोगे तो फिर आप तब तक काम करते रहोगे जब तक आप मर नहीं जाते. तो ये काफी इंस्पायरिंग लाइन्स है लाइक अगर आप इन्वेस्टमेंट सीखना चाह रहे हो, बिकॉज यू नो व्हाट, इन्वेस्टमेंट इज समथिंग, एक पैसिव सोर्स ऑफ इनकम है. अगर लाइक आप, ये एक बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट चीज है कि आप कभी भी सेविंग्स कर करके आप कभी अमीर नहीं बन सकते. Am I right? So, अगर हमारे पास पैसिव इनकम सोर्सेस होना बहुत जरूरी है. सो इन्वेस्टमेंट इज वन ऑफ देम. सो नाउ लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज इन्वेस्टमेंट मैनेजमेंट. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, कैन एनीवन टेल मी व्हाट इज इन्वेस्टमेंट? एनीवन ऑफ यू?
मैम, इट इज लाइक investing our money in any kind of investment avenues. It might be equity shares or buying a house, anything, ma'am.
Okay, great answer. Anyone else?
Yes. A great answer, ma'am. A clap for Alikya ma'am in chat box. Let increase our Alikya ma'am. He has given initiation and taken this. I want everyone to clap in the chat box. Thank you, Sneha ma'am. Thank you, Aishwarya ma'am.
Thank you all. Now, let me tell you what is actually investment. Investment is the action or process of investing money for profit. Whenever you invest something, like whenever you invest your mind, your energy, your money, that is a kind of investment. So basically, when you're talking about the investment for profits, so when you invest your money for profits, that is called investment. Now let's talk about the second word. What is management? Can anyone tell me what is management?
Maintaining or handling the environment or anything like that, ma'am. In a company, in a corporate first.
Yes, kind of right. Some more answers, please.
Keeping everything in a systematically way, arranging them in a systematic way.
Right. Some more answers, please.
To controlling,
managing the activities, or controlling, okay, the activities involved in anything. Yes, ma'am.
Right, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. I'll like sum up the answers, everyone's answers. Thing, it is the process of dealing with or controlling the resources. Okay, now what is investment management? Let us sum up the two words and see what is investment management. It is the handling of financial assets and other investments. Basically, investment means a purchase of an asset which produces return over a period of time. Let us understand what is investment management with the definition. Investment is a process. Investment is a purchase by an individual or institutional investors of either financial or real assets, which produces a return which is commensurate with a risk over a specific period, which a specific future investment period. Can anyone please read out what is written on the screen? Anyone of you, please.
Day one, investment management.
Okay, so 1 second. Is the screen not changing?
Yes, ma'am. No, your screen is not.
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Okay, one second. Is it changing? Yeah, 1 second.
Yeah, no, it's okay, ma'am. No, it's okay.
Okay, is it visible now? Introduction to investment management.
Yes,
okay, great. Okay, can anyone please read out what is written on the screen?
Investment management refers to the handling of financial assets and other investments, not only buying and selling them.
Okay, thank you so much, ma'am. So basically, what is investment management? It is a purchase purchased by an individual or institutional investor. What is an individual? Who is an individual? An individual can be a person, or maybe a company can also be an individual, like the small group of people. They can be called as individual. And institutional investor. Now, what is an institutional investor? When a company invests their money in some shares, or like for the stakeholding, or maybe buying their shares, then that is called institutional investing. When suppose a company wants to buy shares in a startup, so that is called institutional investing. जैसे कि वो angel investors होते हैं, so what they do कि वो लोग एक company में invest करेंगे and उनके equities अपने पास रख लेते हैं, so that is also institutional investing. Now let's see the next part. Why should we invest? What is the purpose of investment? Like whenever you invest, there should be a purpose. Why are you investing? So हम सबके purposes अलग अलग हो सकते हैं. Like किसी का purpose होगा कि उन्हें पैसे बढ़ाने हैं. Some people want they to save their money for some times. So what they do, they put their money into some investment channel, and they relax. And after some years, whenever they want, they take off the money from there. So that is, everyone can have their own goals, financial goals. Now let's see what can be the purposes of investment management. So first one is growing your money. Can I even please read out what are the purposes of investment management one by one? Yeah, anyone?
Ma'am, first one is grow your money.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. So growing your money, as in, this is one generalized purpose that why everyone starts investing. They want to grow their money. They want to get some returns. They want to get high earnings on whatever they have invested. So basically, हमने जितना भी invest किया है उस पे कुछ तो पैसे हमें ज्यादा मिलेंगे. So basically, this is the purpose. Now, second one. Can anyone read out the second point?
Save for retirement.
Okay, thank you, sir. So basically, some people, what they do in their early 20s or 30s, they start investing so that they can save some money for their retirement, like whatever they have planned for financial goals, so that they should try to fulfill, like they can fulfill it after their retirement. So they start investing in their early 20s and 30s. So this is what is called saving for retirement. That can be one purpose. Now, next one, please. Anyone?
Higher returns.
Okay, thank you. So basically, some investors, what they do, they invest their money in such stocks which gives higher returns. Like in that cases, they might face some higher risk also. So when they are hires, they get higher returns. So that can be one purpose, to get higher returns in a short span of time. Next one, please.
Research financial goals.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. So some people, what they do, they make some financial goals. Like after some years, I want this much money in my bank account, or maybe they want to get a car, a branded car, or maybe they want to build a house. So that can be their financial goals. So for that, they start investing. And when they reach their financial goals, they withdraw the money. That is what financial goal is. Next one is build on pre-tax dollars. So let me explain you this thing in detail. So in some countries, what companies do is that they make it compulsory for the employees to invest their some part of the money, some percentage of money into stocks. Why is it so? Because like they will have that money for their retirement. When they get retired, they can withdraw that money. So whatever stock they want to choose, that they can choose, and they can invest their money into stocks. So this is something which is compulsory in some countries. So and for the sixth point, which is qualify for employer matching programs. So that is also same. These both comes under the rule of 401k. So this is something which is compulsory for in like UK and US. Like they need to invest their money, some part of their money, into investments in some like whichever stock they want to choose. Now coming on to seventh one, can anyone read out, please? Seventh one.
Start and expand a business.
Okay, thank you, sir. So whenever someone wants to start a business or someone wants to expand a business, what do they need? They need investment. And how do they get that investment? They get that investment from the investors. So this is what people do. Like either they will bootstrap money. That is also one kind of investment. Bootstrapping is something ki aapke paas mein paise hai. And you get some money from your relatives, from your friends, and that is what is called bootstrapping. And that you invest in your business. And that is the same with expanding a business. So whenever you want to invest money, either you will take loans, either you will ask to your relatives and some of your friends, and then you will invest that money into your business. So that is also one kind of investment. And of course, we know when we start a business and if it grows, we get the returns. And so that the returns, we can obviously give it back to the relatives or friends, whoever from we have taken the money. Now, coming on to the next, which is support others. If like there are some people who like to do social work, so they like investing their money into people. People's talent, maybe it may be crafting, their musical or dancing skills, or maybe any kind of skills. So they invest their money into their skills, not for any profits, but for their satisfaction, they do such activities. Now coming on to next one, which is reduce taxable income. So some people invest their money into stocks or maybe into mutual funds or LICs and other things so that they can reduce their tax income. Now, what is taxable income? If you want to learn what is taxable income, we have another workshop on taxation. You can join that taxation workshop and so that you can learn everything about how you can reduce your taxable income and how you can save on taxes. Now coming on to next, which is be a part of new venture. As I already told you that some of the investors, like they are called angel investors, they invest their money into some small startups or some new ventures, and they keep some equities of that company with them for whatever investment they have given. Now after some years, what they get is if that company grows, they people get higher returns. Whatever they have invested, they get like two or three times more than whatever they have invested. So that's why people like to invest into startups. But there is high risk of in investing into startups, because if that doesn't work, they will lose all the investment. So this is about the purposes. There can be different purposes. Like, you all can have your own purpose. Why do you want to invest? So before investing, before starting to invest, you should know what, why do you actually want to invest? It may be anything. Like, if you want to grow your money, or maybe you want to have some goals, like if you want to travel or whatever. So you should know how much money you want. So you should know your purpose. That's it. So now coming on to the next slide. Types of investment. So basically, there are two types of investment. So the first one is physical or real investment, and the second one is financial investment. Now, coming on to first one, physical or real investment. So basically, physical or real investment is something which, like, when you invest into some physical thing, like maybe real estate, maybe gold, or maybe some machinery, or buy, or maybe if you want to buy a property. So that is all comes under physical physical or real investment. Now, some characteristics, talking about some characteristics of physical and real investment. So basically, physical investment is tangible asset, like which you can feel, which you can see. That is a physical investment. And one more thing about physical investment, that it can be either productive or it may be unproductive. Let's see this with an example. Suppose if you buy a machinery, or maybe if you buy a tractor, then like you have invested your money into buying that machinery or tractor. So talking about this, like, you get some income, some benefits from this, right? So like, you can generate money from this. Like, if you put your machinery to work, then you may generate some money through through that. So that is productive productive investment. Like, you are getting some income from that. But when you invest your money in some assets, like your mobile phone, like many of you might be having iPhone, or maybe some costly phones, or maybe like you can see the assets in around you. You all, in everyone's house, there is a TV, there is a refrigerator. These are all assets. But is that a productive one? No. Is it, you are not generating money through that, right? So it is an unproductive asset. So basically, it is the same thing. Like, physical assets may be either productive or unproductive. Now, coming on to the second one, which is financial investment. So it is the financial investment is something, it is not tangible. These are not tangible investments. See, these investments are evident. Like, these financial investments are evident through a paper, or maybe on electronic claims. Like, for example, when you invest your money into some apps like Upstocks or Zerodha, you can see that all the activities through the app, right? So that is what electronic claims. And talking about, like, if you are investing your money into mutual funds, like, earlier that it was there that people used to buy mutual funds or some stocks through papers. They used to keep papers of it, like, we have bought this much shares, and like, even still it is there, like, people buy stocks and they keep the papers of it, that we have this much we have invested, and these much is my holdings. These are what financial investment is. So talking about some of the examples, if we see what are financial investment. So basically, equity shares are there, then bonds are there, debentures are there, mutual funds, then derivative instruments. These are all financial investments. Now, talking about the next thing, which is investment process. We have learned what is investment. We have learned why should we invest, like, what can be the purpose of investment. Then we have learned type of investment. Now let's see how to invest. How should we start investing? So can anyone read out the first point, please? From the participants, anyone, please?
Investment policy.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. So basically, what is investment policy is, as I already told that it is the same as purpose for investment. So basically you need to define the goal for investment. Why do you want to invest? It can be either to gain more capital, to make it can be for to get regular income, it can be for like to take advantage from the Income Tax Act, or maybe for the safety of their money, like if they want. So these can be some of the reasons, like I have already told you all the reasons why you should invest. So basically you need to define why do you want to invest. Now coming on to the next part, like once you have defined your goal, then what you should do? You should do the investment analysis, which is the second point. Now coming on to second point, after investment goal is determined, you have to analyze the investment channels, like what all things are available, what all channels are available in which you can invest. Now, if you have selected a stock, so what are the available alternatives? What stocks you should choose, which is better, which is risky, which is not risky? So these are all things to be considered. Now, how an investor decides? So there are two types of investors. So basically, one is highly risky investments, and the second one is low risky investments. So what, like there are some investors who don't want to grow their money, they just want to safeguard their money. Like they want to invest their money just so that like after sometimes they can just withdraw their money, and like it should not be like used somewhere. So that's why they invest in their money. Even if they get don't get higher returns, they are satisfied. At least they are getting some returns on whatever the principal amount they have invested. So their basic agenda for investment is their safeguarding of their money. Now there are some second type of investors who are like dynamic investors. They don't care about the risk. They are kind of risk takers. As I've given you the example of Dhirubhai Ambani, he was one of the risk takers. He used to invest his money, but he used to have all the knowledge, like which company is going to do well in future. So he used to invest in such companies, and he used to gain higher profits. So higher the risk, higher the profits, but it's not sure that you will get the higher profits. That is a risk. So there are dynamic investors who do investment in such companies from where they can get higher returns. They are called dynamic investors. Now, the next part is investment validation. So how investment validation is done? You know, whenever you want to invest your money, you should know the value of investment changes. There are many things which affect the valuation of your shares. So it can be market condition, economy. So whenever the economy changes, the market condition also changes. So when you have invested all your money into many stocks, so that becomes a portfolio for you. So you should keep an eye on all the stocks, like the valuation or how the valuation of your portfolio is changing. Because if some of the stocks are not doing well due to some changes in market, then you should sell off that stock. But you should also do all the analysis, which we are going to learn in upcoming sessions, that how to do all the analysis. So you should do all the analysis, that is that company not doing well just for the temporary reasons, or maybe it will not do well in future also. So you should do that analysis, and then you should decide that either you should like sell off that stocks, or you should hold that stocks. So this is what investment valuation is. Now to the next point, which is portfolio construction and feedback. So one of the main objective of the investors is to maximize the returns and minimize the risk. So basically you should invest in those stocks which are like low risk and which will give you higher returns. So this is the main aim of investors. Like it is always said, there is a quote that never put all your eggs in the same basket. this is because if one basket like if one basket breaks and like the egg breaks, so it other also has like at least other eggs will be saved. Same is the case with the share market. Like agar like if one share is not doing well, at least you can get the profits from other shares or other channels. So that's why always invest your money or always invest your stock in different channels. This is what portfolio construction is. Try to build your portfolio such a way that you can get more and more returns and with less risk. So this is what portfolio construction is. Now coming on to the next part. Is my screen changing?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you so much for response. So what are the factors to be considered while making an investment decision? First of all, there are like five main factors which are to be considered while making your investment decisions. So first one of which is returns. Now coming on to returns, there are like two kind of returns. One is return on capital value and second one is return on investment. So what is return on capital value is whatever principal amount which you have invested, you should at least get that much back. Suppose aapne invest kiya hai 5,000 rupees into share market. So at least 5,000 rupees, if you are facing losses or if that company is not doing well at that point, so you should get at least 5,000 rupees back in your account. That is a return on capital value. Now coming on to second one, which is return on investment. That is something when you get some profits. Suppose you have invested the 5,000 rupees in some XYZ company's shares. Now that company does well and there are some profits. So you get suppose 500 rupees more on that. So that is what is return on investment. You are getting 500 rupees as profit. So that is return on investment. Now come on to second point, which is risk. Now, can anyone please tell me what is risk? Any one of you?
Ma'am, risk is the uncertainty of future.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Anyone else, please?
Ma'am, we can call your name.
Okay, actually, I cannot see the participants. So, Pavan sir, can you please help me with the, can you please take any participant's name?
Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am, sure. Lahri, ma'am, can you answer that? Hello, Lahri, ma'am.
Hello.
Hello, ma'am. How are you, ma'am?
Yes, sir. I'm good. Thank you. What about you?
And ma'am is asking about risk. Can you answer it?
Actually,
yes, ma'am.
Actually, could you please repeat it? The voice is breaking. Actually,
okay. Can you please tell me what is risk?
It is actually if you are not gaining our principal amount at least back. So it is meant by risk. It is like a security for the amount that we have invested in a particular portfolio.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. What energy, ma'am. Let's clap for Lahri, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Very good, ma'am. Yes, sir. Very, very good energy.
Okay, thank you, sir. So basically risk is something, it is occurrence of Sneha ma'am said, basically risk is occurrence of losses. So whenever you buy a stock, you should always analyze that, is there any risk in buying that? Like, is there any scams or any malpractices? Really, is there anything such kind of activity related to that company? So you should basically, how are you going to do that? Basically, you can refer some news, then many information you can get it from internet as well, then from even word of mouth, like some people keep telling you about like this company is not doing well, should we buy that shares or not. So these are some kind of sources from where you can get if there is a risk in buying that company's shares or not. So you should always keep in mind that what can be the risk. Either if you can even refer money control for that, and you can see like if there is like some fluctuations, regular fluctuations in that company, then it is a high risk, high risky share. And if like the profit stability is there, then the risk is quite low. But fundamental analysis is very important. So you should always keep in mind that risk can be the risk associated with the share prices of that company should be low while deciding that you need to buy that shares or not. Now coming on to the next part, which is safety. Now what is safety? The safety is safety of investment. Now coming on to what investment? So the basically safety of your principal investment, whatever amount you have invested, at least that should be secured. That should not have any kind of risk. You should not get into losses. That is what safety is. So as I already told about the risk, so you should keep in mind that whenever you are buying any stock, at least you should see that at least your principal amount should be safe. And when to buy that stock, when to sell that stock, you should decide that through all these points. Now coming on to liquidity, the next point. So what is liquidity? Is convertibility of investment into cash. How fast you can convert your investment into cash. Like if you have invested, suppose for example, we have Chitrangda ma'am. So if she invests some money into some shares of Tata Motors, so she needs to see that first, that how much she can, how fast she can convert their bonds or maybe that shares into cash. If she needs it urgently, how will she do it? She like if she's doing it through Upstox or any app, so she can get it in like 2 days, like that much time is required. But if some companies has their policies that after this many days only they can be it can be converted into stocks. So which stocks to buy, in which channel you should invest, or which asset you should invest, that should be that you should keep in mind according to your convenience or according to what you want, like how much time and how much time you want your money to be liquidated. So the more fast it is liquidated, the more profitable it will be for you, because if you need it urgently, you can use that money, you can just convert that asset or maybe that investment into cash. So you should see the liquidity also of that particular stock. Now coming on to the next point, which is marketability. So there are some things like some stocks, or you need to see which, like if it is transferable to someone else or not. Like if there is physical gold, if you are investing into physical gold or any other assets like car or maybe a house, that is also investment. So you should need to see if you are investing into some asset. So is it marketable or not? Can you transfer that to someone else, or how fast can you transfer it to someone else? Bonds, can you transfer it to someone else or not? So you should keep all these things in mind. Now, you know, whenever you need to see that, you need to make a decision on how to invest, you need to be aware about the companies, about the market, about the economy. Now, how are you going to be aware about that? So there are some sources of information from where you can get all the information on on the shares, about the companies, about their valuation, about their balance sheets. So all these informations you can first of all refer to in Google. Then there is one more reliable source, that is Money Control, and the other one is Google Finance. These are some reliable sources where from where you can get all the information. Now talking about some information, then what information you should gather is world affairs, then natural economic affairs, industry information, as you all can see on the screen. industry information, data or mutual funds, then company information, security market information, then security price quotations. These are informations which you should always have. Like, you should be aware about general, like, these are all general news, so which you can get from anywhere. So this is what about today's session is. Now I want to end the session with a story. There was a man who used to sell newspapers when he was younger, around age of like 12 or 15. So he used to sell newspapers. What he did with that, whatever money he got, his family condition was not bad, but still he wanted to earn on his own. So he used to sell newspapers. Then after that, whatever money he got, he invested it into a particular pinball game, and that game, like, he bought that machine and he installed that in one of the barber's shop. So when he got returns from that, he did the partnership with the barber that whatever profits he will get, he will do, like, we will do 50-60 or maybe 50-50, he thought, and or maybe 40-60. So whatever profits he got from that, he invested into another pinball machine, and he invested, he did partnership with almost 9 to 10 barbers in one particular area. So whatever profits he got from all of that, he used to collect all the money, and after some years, he just sold off that sold off all the pinball machines to someone. That became a proper business model what he used to run. So he got profits from all the selling of that business, and then he started investing that money. So first he started he invested his money into real estate. Like, he bought a land of 40 acres at the age of 18. He was having his own place of 40 acres. That is itself a very big thing at the age of 18. Now, can anyone tell me who was that man? Any one of you? You might have heard the story. Does anyone knows? If you don't know, please say no. Not a problem.
I think no one knows, ma'am.
No?
Yeah.
Who? What did you say?
I think no one knows about it, ma'am.
Okay. If I tell you, you all know the name. Then?
Ma'am, someone, Darshita has answered that, Warren Buffett.
Exactly. The man was Warren Buffett.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, ma'am. So the man is Warren Buffett. Like, everyone knows that he is one of the biggest investors. He is the world's third richest man in the world. And how did he become the most richest man in the world? How? Just by investing his money. Like, he learned everything. His father was a stockbroker. His father owned a stockbroker company. So what he used to do, he used to go and study all the books whichever was available in the firm. So he initially, how did he start it? He did not start it by investing his money into the into different things or different assets. He initially started by investing in knowledge. So that's why it is said that investment in knowledge is the biggest investment. So that is the biggest example how we can learn that we can learn from Warren Buffett. So if anyone has any doubt, you all can ask your questions.
So participants, anyone? If you have any doubt, you can open up now. Feel free to ask the doubts.
Yes, anyone, any doubt?
And you can ask also in chat box, I will read up.
Okay, thank you for your response, sir.
Ma'am, I think no one has doubt, ma'am, so we can continue.
Okay, should I ask one question? Can I ask one question, last question?
Yes, ma'am, sure, we can.
Okay, thank you, sir. From whom did Warren Buffett learn investing?
Benjamin Graham.
Benjamin Graham.
Okay. Okay, there was one more person about whom, like, I don't think so many of you might be knowing. He was Philip Fisher. Just a fact, like, for a fact, I'm telling you. He was Philip Fisher. So he, like, Benjamin Graham introduced us to value investing. Now, what is value? Just this is, like, the session has ended. I'm just giving this you extra information. So what is value investing? Value investment is something when you invest into some shares which are undervalued. जैसे कि किसी price किसी shares का price कम है, किसी company के shares को undervalued किया गया है, and तब हम उसे खरीद लेते हैं, and after when that company does well and the share prices rises, at that time you sell that shares. So what you're going to get is purely profits. So that is what Benjamin Graham has taught to, and that is what Warren Buffett learned from him. And what Philip Fisher had told was like buying as many shares as possible. Like, jab time acha chal raha ho, buy as many shares as possible. So what he did, what Warren Buffett made his own perception, like he took 15% of teachings from like a, Warren Buffett himself says that he is 15% Philip Fisher and 85% Benjamin Graham. So what he does is, jab bhi unka company ke jo undervalued hai, so he does the all the analysis, and he like talking about Philip Fisher. So whenever a company is undervalued, he bought वो इतने ज्यादा शेयर्स खरीद लेते हैं उनके पास में कि उनके पास में अच्छा खासा, ताकि उनको आगे जाके अच्छा खासा प्रॉफिट मिलता है. सो दिस इज व्हाट अबाउट वॉरेन बुफे इज. थैंक यू सो मच. लाइक इफ यू ऑल हैव एनी काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस, यू कैन आस्क मी राइट नाउ, और इवन आफ्टर द सेशन इज ओवर यू कैन आस्क एनी क्वेश्चंस इन द ग्रुप आल्सो.
थैंक यू दीक्षा मैम फॉर टुडेस प्रेजेंटेशन. And I would like to thank all the participants for joining today and making it successful. And we have another 4 more days to go for the workshop of investment. And if you have any doubts, you can ask now, and you can also give it in chat box. And you can also provide your doubts in, ask your doubts in WhatsApp group so that they can give you a solution. And so it's time to for today's to wind up. And I would like to thank you all of you for joining, and we will continue tomorrow at 6 p.m. and we will provide a link in our WhatsApp group, so stay connected with the WhatsApp group and be ready with that, so you can make success for all these 4 days. Thank you everyone. So the participants
just a minute. I want to add something over here.
Yes, ma'am, you can manage.
Yeah, thank you, Pawan sir, for this. And thank you, Diksha ma'am, for such a great this one. Giving a great presentation, explaining everyone in a very layman language. And today I'd like to give you all one practical, like, since we are already in the investment workshop, right? So can you all make an Excel sheet and the things that should be there, like total number of shares? It will be around 2000. Total amount should okay, I'm not giving any amount in this, just you need to invest in total number of shares is 2000, only this much you need to be remember. Other than that, you can choose any company, and you can choose a shares, mutual fund, anything. Make an Excel sheet and add like which company you will be investing in, then whether you will be investing in share or mutual fund, and how much return you will get in investing into it. And let me know by tomorrow. Like today, you can check on the money control, as Diksha ma'am has said to you all. And tomorrow, again, let us discuss and how much percentage of return you can get. And tomorrow we can discuss with you. Yes.
Yeah, we will ask them in Monday evening, ma'am. Tomorrow is offer market.
Oh, sorry. Tomorrow, yes. Saturday and Sunday is going on. Thanks for reminding me. But other than days, like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, you can see to it.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, do we have a workshop like tomorrow, ma'am?
Yes, it will be all continuous 5 days. A workshop will be there.
This assignment should be submitted by tomorrow.
Yes, today you can see, you can check. But no, today already the market is closed. So you can start with Monday onwards. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, 3 days we have. You can learn right now, today and tomorrow. And then you can start with that. Okay. So you can go.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
We should invest for how much period?
Sorry, I did not get your question.
What is the period? For how much we have to invest?
Okay, it's like total number of shares or total number of units. Whether you are using mutual fund, it will be number of units. And if you're using shares, then it will be 2000. Written in the chat box.
Ma'am, he's asking about for what much time? Like he's asking the period for investment.
Okay, period. It could be like any, on a daily basis, you can check. If you want some more time for the investment, if you have a particular strategy in your mind for some long term or short term, depending upon you. But for me, it's like for every day. How much like you can get the return? You need to check that.
Intraday trading, maybe.
Yes, kind of intraday. So that you can learn. That is a best part. And one more thing I would like to share with you all, like as ma'am has mentioned about the fundamental analysis. Fundamental analysis is basically on the revenue of the company. So yesterday there was Reliance, which gave the quarter result. Okay. And for Reliance, it's Reliance Industries. It has given the growth of around 60% a hike in profit, okay, in revenue. So accordingly, you can take the call whether it's good for the investment or not, as far as the fundamental analysis is concerned. Today, there was a result of ICICI Bank. That quarter report has already announced. So you can go with that quarter report. Okay. So now you can think of like, yes, now since already there are many companies whose quarter reports are out. So according to that also, you can go with taking a call, because as soon as the quarter reports are out, as soon as there is a news of profit, the shares prices hikes. Okay. So you can think of it in which stock you can purchase or in which stock you can sell. But instead of if something is going increasing, like you should not purchase an increasing trade when it is already in a very low price, then you should purchase. And when it increases, then you should sell. Right. But now it's up to you all, like in what way you can invest. Just giving you all an idea, sharing you all the information. Some companies' quarter reports are already out and their shares prices have already increased. Right. So you can think of the companies. Many companies you all have to research on it, and then we can proceed. And yes, everything you can get more idea, more updates in this complete investment workshop. And other than that, if anyone is also looking for this investment workshop, can join by tomorrow. It also, like by tomorrow, we have been open for joining with this workshop. And yes, our taxation workshop is also coming back to back after this. And anyone is interested, many of them are interested for knowing the taxation, some TDS, GST, income tax, So we are going with the taxation workshop as well. So anyone is interested can join with that workshop. Okay. That's it from my side. Thank you, everyone.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. And participants, if you have any doubt about the task, you can ask in WhatsApp group. Ma'am will clear about it. And thank you for joining. And participants can leave now.
Thank you, everyone, for joining. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dikshana.
Chetan, please stop.